Hey, folks, welcome back to Montreal Forum and Coach's Corner. Let me tell you, a lot of good things happened to me here in the Forum and a lot of bad things. But one of the good things was when I played for the Boston Bruins in the semifinals against Montreal. Good-looking guy or what? Now, John Beliveau, big John Beliveau, he tried to score on long John Henderson. Are you kidding? Look who's coming to the rescue. Donald Lescheri knocked him down on his keister. John Beliveau, indeed.
Brendan Shanahan. Oh.
Of all the things in the last 10 years I've had and watched, this is upsets me the most. We had a great thing, Coach's Corner, on him. He's just scored a hat trick. After Coach's Corner, he goes out and scores a goal, and then he breaks his ankle. And you know, all you kids, I've been giving it to all those guys laying on the ice. Watch this guy. Go ahead and roll it. Watch this guy with a broken ankle. Watch this. Now, look, he's got a broken ankle. Look at him. He jumps over the boards. That's the kind of guy you want. Brendan Shanahan, God love him, watch. I've had a broken ankle, folks. It is the most painful thing in the world. I tell you, you cry, you're in such pain. And this is the thing that's upset me more in the last 10 years that I've been on Hockey Night in Canada. Last week I had Mueller. This is why I've been hurt. And the week before. Now, you kids out there, I know you can't do this, but look at the heart of this here guy. First of all, we're going to show you. I want to show the hit again with the puck. What was Dougie shooting? Go ahead, Mark, roll it right now. Show it right now, the hit and everything like this. Now, there he is, cut there. He come back. By the way, Dr. Douglas, now here's the shot comes out. I don't know what Gilmore was shooting at. He puts it out here. He comes to watch it. Dr. Douglas put in 25 stitches in 4 minutes, a record. He comes back. There it is again. Now, if you're ever going to bail, the score is 3-0. The crowd is booing. Let's say I can't see out of my eye. That's what most guys would say. Let me see. And Dr. Douglas put it in. Here's what he does when he comes back. He's still in there banging and smashing. He gets caught. Watch coming back. He's got 25 stitches, blood running down his eye.
You ever cut this bed?
Oh, it was like I had 17 stitches in the eye one time. Looked like I had 3 eyes. Anytime he comes back, he tries to do it. And now watch him on the bench. Hey, Nedved said he worked with him last night. Look, is that a warrior? He'd take the bullet for you. Nedved said, I worked on his line. I got 3 assists, because if you don't, Kirk's all over you. A warrior and a hockey player. First of all, this is not a cheap shot, all right? Now, if Marty wanted to kill him, he would have, good job. Now, Dougie cuts into center ice like that. He deserved to get zonked like that. He's just lucky. Alfie Samuelson wasn't coming across there like that. Now, Wendell, or he'd be in the Kingston General Hospital. Wendell, being the good guy he is, he sees him there. He says, let's drop it and let's go, Marty. 2 good guys going at it. Love Marty and love Wendell. Nothing wrong with it at all. It was about an even there. Wendell happened to cut him, but look at how Marty comes along pretty good, too. 2 good guys. I have the hit of all time.
Yes, you do.
I do have the hit from Prince George. Corey Sarich on Quinn Hancock. Roll it right now if you've seen a better hit. Now watch the little Sue goes up there. Is that the hit of all time? I think we see it again, don't we? Can you believe Quinn gets up and gets 2 goals after this?
Lovely.
One more thing, my old defense partner, Bob McCammon. Okay, see what he said last week. This is for my grandson.
Just exhibition preseason, and we were playing the Quebec Aces. I remember we were leading with 2 minutes to go. He grabbed one of the Quebec Aces and gave him a pretty good thumping. And I said after the game, I said, Don, what did this guy do to you? He says, oh, nothing. He said, I just wanted to make sure I hadn't lost it over the summer.
How to stop it. Let him go. Just say, let him go. And I'll tell you, I guarantee you, they're pushing and shoving. I'm not coming to your golf tournament. I'm not coming to your golf tournament.
So you don't buy that the referee taking one guy out and giving him a penalty won't do it?
What was his fault? So the referee goes, it's up. We're going to start giving him discretion?
Well, the theory is that that little penalty would dissuade it, but there's penalties now, right?
Let him go, and I guarantee you no more scrubs, as you know, as a referee.
Okay, now listen to this one. I'm going to give you an imitation of Kevin Collins, okay, when there's a fight on. Can I do that?
Sure.
Okay, here he is now. Watch this, folks. Here it is. There's looks like there's going to be a fight. Oh, stop now. Stop off the violence. You, over there. Everybody.
Doing his job.
Drives me nuts. Animated.
Now, this really bugs me, I'll tell you. Watch this cheap shot hit on Cam Neely. See the knee out there?
That was the end of the Bruins and Cam Neely for a long time. Cam got up though and finished the series and finished the game being the great guy he is. Get up, Cam. Now here's what really bugs me. Now watch Samuelson come in. Now see the big mask there. Now watch, he nails Cam right in the face. Cam can't hit him back in the face. Watch him put his visor down on his chest and keep pushing. See the visor down there? That bugs me. Cam gives him a little shot here though. Hooking and holding, give him a shot. That's it, way to go, Cam. Another one, gee, that guy bugs me. Here he is again. Give him a shot, Cam. Knock that helmet and visor off. You know, when I see this stuff, it makes my blood boil. I'll tell you one thing right now. If this was the old Bruins, there'd be one dead Swedish meatball now.
You know, just one other thing. The Sporting News, big publication here, had a story on Paul Laws of Florida.
Hey, no.
Great fighter. They said the other tough guys are Probert, Kasparaitis, and Ulf Samuelson.
Makes you cry, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are supposed to be hockey guys. Kasparaitis and Samuelson, fighters. Two turtle Russians. Anyhow, I'm absolutely infuriated, and you people will be too. You Cam Neely fans and people who love a good all-around Canadian boy. I'm sitting having a bowl of soup, watching it on satellite.
Here he is, a spoon or a fork?
I could have had a fork grated through somebody's heart. Now, we're going to show you something. This is absolutely awful. Let me just set it up, Larry, before it is. Cam's standing in front of the net. And watch this, Samuelson. When are we going to learn about this guy? Waxed Cam in the back of the head. Now, watch this. Larry, roll that. And just watch this here. Now watch this, he's just standing, find Rothvillat, see him get whacked in the head, he drops his gloves like any normal man would do, look at the, whoa, I almost said it, look at him turtling, he won't do anything, he's grabbing out, Cam Neely is out, Cam Neely is out of the game, Sutter, they had to hold him, I guess so, absolutely ridiculous, Kuharsky, the worst call, not in hockey, in sports.
Everybody knew that Neely and Samuelson might be a problem in this game, so Cam had to be wary, don't you think?
Look, I don't mind dives like Billy Barber used to do, but to lay there on the ice like you've been shot by a 404 Magnum, it's not the Canadian way to do it. Get up, Darian, get up! And of all guys, an Ordy dive. Watch Mike Foligno do a triple somersault. Whoa, around, up, down, beauty. Mario gets a 10 here. Watch this little tap. Now watch. And he just, watch this now. Little shot. Boom, oh, around. Looks like Foreman hit him. This is the best one of all. Watch Bob Probst get zonked by Murray Craven. Now watch now. This is what I call a twirl. Down, around, oh, beauty. He should be in the acting class. Now watch him now, the referee's standing there, he pushes away. Ref, I am really hurt now. Go to one knee now, that's it. Honest, I am hurt. And here's the old blood routine, Makarov, no, he doesn't got any. And now, Mario, yeah, I got it, yeah. Steven says, yeah, that's blood, yeah.
What did you think of the little shot on Claude Lemieux?
Claude Lemieux, help me through this, okay? Claude Lemieux, he didn't do his turtle act, he did his caterpillar act. You want the caterpillar act? This is the caterpillar act of Claude Lemieux, and it's a damn shame because he's a good hockey player.
You know,
show that?
When Dino was down in the...
Are we going to show the caterpillar?
Sure. When Dino was down in the first
game... Oh, there he is. That's a caterpillar. In hockey, we call that the caterpillar. This man is dead, never to rise again. Doesn't he look like a caterpillar? But he blossoms after that. First of all, you know what I'm talking about. Some of you mums and dads don't like to see this here. It makes me sick, the cheapest shot of all time. And you know the one I'm talking about. I was talking to Dave today in the hotel, his uncle, eh? And he tells me his optical bone was broken, his nose was broken, his jaw was broken, he had six teeth almost go down his throat, he had 60 stitches inside his mouth and 30 outside. All summer he sucked his food through a straw. You know, you can't forget stuff like that, folks. And in hockey, I know some of you writers and fair play commissions, things like that. Two wrongs don't make a right, but it's an eye for an eye in hockey, and this is the way that you know this was going to come, and once it's over, it's over. Now, first of all, let's see the hit, the cheap shot of all time. Let's see it. Now, he was just going to change here. He's completely unaware, and as you know, he hit the top there, crushed everything there, was unbelievable, even gets whacked around a little bit there. I mean, I felt so sorry. I saw him this summer. He still fully wasn't recovered. Now, you remember a few years ago, this was after sticking Cam in the mouth with a stick. Watch what Claude does again. You know, he's not a bad hockey player, but why he turtles like this all the time? Look at him. I mean, a human being.
I'm getting carried away here. For his own respect, you think he'd stand up. Unbelievable. You see how the other players went to help him? Now, here he is again, looking like this. There goes Darren. He misses him with a shot. Now, watch him turtle again. Watch him. He goes down and turtles again.
Claude says he was cut right there. He did have an 18-stitch cut.
But anyhow, whatever happens, look at him. I mean, for his own respect. And there's Shanahan hitting Patty, because what happens there, you know what happens after that. But I'll tell you, this here guy deserves everything he gets. And there's Darren going out for the first star, or one of the stars. He got a standing ovation from all the people, and so he should have a winning goal, straightened it out. Kids out there, always give credit. Kozlov, he got hit. Let's see it right now, and he got up. Okay, now you've seen this one. Whack, he comes across. This is trolley tracks, cutting in the center, kids. Remember I told you, cutting in the center. But watch, he remembers. Don Cherry says, don't lay there. I'm getting up. Yes, sir. A rush is getting up. Look at this guy. He's hearing bells now, folks. He's asking where he is. He says, I'm in Siberia, I think. But anyhow, he gets up. Pretty soon, watch him. Now, look at that Jofa helmet. That's kind of funny, isn't it? Anyhow, he gets up. Way to go. What's his first name?
Looks like a Bobby there with the strap under the
nose. What's his first name?
Slava. Vyacheslav.
Something like that.
Wait, I have to say something. I think the National Hockey League is going nuts. Commissioner, I think you have to start thinking and think about what guys like me know what's talking, not the left-wing pinko media, bleeding hearts guys. Now watch what they do the other night. Now at the end of this, that they appeared, I'm going to let talk to you. At the end of this, they come out for the third period and they're talking. Now all they're doing is talking, right? Now, what do you see? Well, okay, that's enough. Now, all they're doing is talking. Now watch the referee, little twit, throws them off. Look at the little twit, throws them off. They go, what? What for? What are we talking? Listen, they don't hit anymore. They're trying to get hitting out of the game. They're, what are you, nuts? I know, I've been saying.
He says to John Scott, we're going?
Yeah, can't believe it. Now get this.
That's funny.
They're taking hitting out of the game. Mandatory visors will be next. I guarantee you that's coming. There'll be no fighting. Are you nuts? Are you nuts? You're trying to draw people down in the South. I guarantee you, if you took my big bad Bruins, if you took the Lunch Pail Gang down there, you would pack them. If you took the Bond Street Bullies down there, you'd pack them. It's NFL country, where the idea is to kill the quarterback. Action, banging all the time. Do you think in Florida they walk back? Yeah, they're doing a great job. What you think the people in Florida and all those places, as they go out, say, what a lovely pass. But if there's a fight, you're committing suicide, Commissioner. Smarten up.
Folks, hockey's a tough game, and here's a couple of tips how to avoid injuries. Number one, don't pick a fight with Bobby Probert. And here's a few more from Coach's Corner. Let's go.
Don't try to put your stick over his. I was talking to the two kids from that you're going to have. What are their names? You forgot their names.
No, I haven't. Derek Inanen and Rob Asselton.
And they said, yeah, he made a big mistake putting the stick over Probert's stick. He'll let you stand there, but don't try to push him and try to be a tough guy. Okay, let's show that. Mark, can you show it right now? Now watch them standing there. See how he puts the stick over Probert's stick? You don't do that, folks, because if you do that, and you jostle him around, and you want to play with the bull, you're going to get the horn. And here comes the horn right now. And I can't understand the Leafs. They're going, look at the Leafs going, say, hey, ref, did you see that? Now they're looking around for quarters, and Probert's saying, you mean nobody's coming over? At least somebody should have got over and said, Mr. Probert, I don't think you should have done that. But nobody did.
Okay, now this is the big thing. I had to get that over with quick. It's 1 o'clock this morning. I'm down in my basement. I'm watching Anaheim and Vancouver. Anaheim won 3-0. I won't say Mighty Ducks. I'm watching Edmonton, Chicago. Chicago won. Okay? I hear Blue going nuts upstairs, just barking and going crazy. So I go up. There's a car accident, or actually a pickup accident right in front of my house. There's policemen there. There's firemen there. Great guys. So I naturally put on, and I go outside. What's going on? It's 30 below zero with the wind factor and everything. Here are these guys here and everything. They say, what are you doing, Grapes? Said, I'm down watching the game. I said, by the way, did you see Probert and McSorley? They said, we don't see nothing. We work shifts. We never see any of the games and everything. They said, yeah, and I'm telling them about it. One of the best of all time.
Not going to glorify violence.
No, no, I never do that. They said, Grapes, for us, would you show it? For the guys that keep us safe, stout-hearted men,
That's, I'm going to show this one, all right?
But you're going to sing that song that you always sing?
I'm not doing.
You're chicken?
Am I chicken?
Yeah.
all right.
I'll dare you.
All right. Give me some men who are stout-hearted men who will fight for the right they adore. Shoulder to shoulder and bolder, and I'll soon give you 10,000 more. Anyhow.
Every year in the playoffs.
All right.
At least
here it is. Now listen, this is one of the best, folks. Watch this. Marty McSorley, two, I've had them on the grapevine. Last night, they love one another. This is the best, folks. We're all going to go down. Might be my last coach's corner. Everybody's up. 17,000 people going crazy. Two beautiful guys. I don't know why they keep showing the benches. Anyhow, get back to the fight. Get that head out of the way. That always bugs me.
A great director.
Anyhow, here we go. Two great guys now. Watch this here. One getting $1.8 million. The other guy, Bobby Probert's a free agent. Next year, he's going to get over $1 million.
He's
now watch. You see that? You see that? He let him go. Probert, the little honor there. He didn't hit him and he was there. There's honor amongst these guys. Now he gets the sweater off and going again. All right. He got caught there, a beauty. Probert's going. This is the longest one of all time, I'll tell you. Watch this here now. He gets the arm loose. Got this sweater. He's got his tie downs on, I think, this time. I think Bobby's got his tie on this time. $1.3 million, I'm saying. Remember I said in the playoffs last year, Marty get $2 million? Remember that?
Yes.
All right, he got $2 million. Now watch, it's getting near the end here, folks. It's 1:42, I timed it. Whoa, two strong guys. Here they are. Now watch them at the end. Watch them at the end. They bump one another, and they say as they skate away, good show, folks, good show. It's coming near the end.
Delay a game penalty.
You're making fun of them, eh? You cannot believe how tired they are right now, folks. You can't believe. And Marty has got his helmet welded on, I'm almost sure. Two good linesmen there. They won't jump in. Now watch them at the end. They just kind of bump heads, said, good show. See that? Good show. And he touches them on the head. Good buddies. Two good guys. That's beautiful. Wow. You see what I mean? Beautiful. Could be my last coach's corner. That's for the guys that keep us safe, the firemen and the police.
For your birthday. You know, you